Pregabalin is an anticonvulsant drug used to treat neuropathic pain conditions and fibromyalgia, and for the treatment of partial onset seizures in combination with other anticonvulsants. In this video, let's find found. What is pregabalin? What is pregabalin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking pregabalin? How does pregabalin work? How to use pregabalin? What is pregabalin? Pregabalin, sold under the brand name Lyrica among others, is an anticonvulsant, analgesic, and anxiolytic medication used to treat epilepsy, neuropathic pain, fibromyalgia, restless leg syndrome, opioid withdrawal, and generalized anxiety disorder. Pregabalin also has anxiolytic properties. Pregabalin was approved for medical use in the United States in 2004. It was developed as a successor to the related gabapentin. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 78th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 9 million prescriptions. What is pregabalin used for? Pregabalin is indicated for the management of neuropathic pain associated with diabetic peripheral neuropathy, postherpetic neuralgia, fibromyalgia, neuropathic pain associated with spinal cord injury, and as adjunctive therapy for the treatment of partial onset seizures in patients 1 month of age and older. Contraindication. Pregabalin is contraindicated in patients who have a known hypersensitivity to pregabalin. Side effects. Very common, greater than 10% of people with pregabalin, dizziness, drowsiness. Common, 1 to 10% of people with pregabalin, blurred vision, diplopia, increased appetite and subsequent weight gain, euphoria, confusion, vivid dreams, changes in libido, increase, irritability, ataxia, attention changes, feeling high, abnormal coordination, memory impairment, tremors, dysarthria, paresthesia, vertigo, dry mouth and constipation, vomiting and flatulence, erectile dysfunction, fatigue, peripheral edema, feeling the effects of drunkenness, abnormal walking, anemia, nasopharyngitis, increased creatine kinase level. Infrequent, 0.1 to 1% of people with pregabalin, depression, lethargy, agitation, anorgasmia, hallucinations, myoclonus, hypoesthesia, hyperesthesia, tachycardia, excessive salivation, hypoglycemia, flushing, rash, muscle cramp, myalgia, arthralgia, urinary incontinence, dysuria, thrombocytopenia, kidney calculus. Rare, less than 0.1% of people with pregabalin, neutropenia, first-degree heart block, hypotension, hypertension, pancreatitis, dysphagia, aguria, rhabdomyolysis, suicidal thoughts or behavior. Pharmacodynamic. Although the structure of pregabalin is similar to gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA, it does not bind to GABA receptors. Instead, it binds the alpha-2-delta subunit of presynaptic voltage-gated calcium channels in the central nervous system. Pregabalin does not modulate dopamine receptors, serotonin receptors, opiate receptors, sodium channels, or cyclooxygenase activity. Mechanism of action. Although the mechanism of action has not been fully elucidated, studies involving structurally related drugs suggest that presynaptic binding of pregabalin to voltage-gated calcium channels is key to the anti-seizure and antinociceptive effects observed in animal models. By binding presynaptic to the alpha-2-delta subunit of voltage-gated calcium channels in the central nervous system, pregabalin modulates the release of several excitatory neurotransmitters including glutamate, substance P, norepinephrine, and calcitonin gene-related peptide. In addition, pregabalin prevents the alpha-2-delta subunit trafficked from the dorsal root ganglia to the spinal dorsal horn, which may also contribute to the mechanism of action. Although pregabalin is a structural derivative of the inhibitory neurotransmitter gamma-aminobutyric acid, GABA, it does not bind directly to GABA or benzodiazepine receptors. Half-life. The elimination half-life of pregabalin is 6.3 hours. Dose. Diabetic peripheral neuropathic pain. Regular release capsules. Initial, 50 mg, POQ8HR. Maintenance, may increase to 100 mg, POQ8HR, within 1 week, as needed, not to exceed 300 mg per day. Extended release tablets. Initial, 165 mg, POQ day. Maintenance, may increase to 330 mg, POQ day, within 1 week, based on response and tolerability, not to exceed 330 mg, POQ day. See also administration. Postherpetic neuralgia. Regular release capsules. Initial, 150 to 300 mg/day, PO divided Q8-12 HR, maintenance, may increase to 300 mg per day, divided Q8-12 HR, after 1 week, added. Extended release tablets. Initial, 165 mg, POQ day. Maintenance, may increase to 330 mg, POQ day, within 1 week, based on response and tolerability, not to exceed 330 mg, POQ day. Patients experience insufficient pain relief following 2 to 4 weeks of treatment with 330 mg POQ day and tolerate the ER tablets, may be treated with up to 660 mg POQ day. Fibromyalgia. Regular release capsules and oral solution only. Initial, 70 mg POQ 12 HR, 150 mg per day. Maintenance, may increase to 150 mg Q12HR after 1 week as needed. Recommended dose is 300 to 400 mg/day. Owing to dose-dependent adverse reactions, doses greater than 450 mg per day are not recommended. Partial onset seizures. Regular release capsules and oral solution only. Indicated as adjunctive therapy for treatment of partial onset seizures. Initial, 150 mg per day, PO divided Q8-12 HR, means, based on clinical response and tolerability, may increase dose in weekly increments, not to exceed 600 mg per day. Efficacy of adjunctive pregabalin in patients taking gabapentin has not been evaluated in controlled trials, consequently, no dosing recommendations can be made when pregabalin is used with pentin. Neuropathic pain with spinal cord injury. Regular release capsules and oral solution only. Initial, 75 mg POQ 12 HR, 150 mg per day, may increase within 1 week to 300 mg per day PO divided Q 12 HR. If there is insufficient pain relief after 2 to 3 weeks and 300 mg per day dose is tolerated, may increase dose again up to 600 mg per day PO divided Q 12 HR. Safety advice. Advice and warnings for the use of pregabalin during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category C risk cannot be ruled out. That's all the information about pregabalin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.